Hello, my friends. Today, I want to show you something about Strikelines cards. I want to do my best to explain to you what these maps can do. When I wanted to buy them, when I saw them online on Facebook actually, and I see what they're capable of, before I make up my mind and buy them, I really wanted to see how they work in somebody's boat, a real review, and I couldn't find nothing. So I decided to talk to the company, tell them if they have anything like that. They told me no, so I said, you know what, I can make a nice video for you, for people to see in the future. They decided to go with it. They gave me a very good deal on it. I pay for them, but they gave me a good deal on it. I didn't know which one to get. Either the Verify Rex or the 3D Island Sound card that they have made from all the way west from Manhattan up to, I don't know, somewhere Black Island Sound. I didn't know which one to choose, so I got both and they gave me a great deal for it. And I promised them that I'll make a video so for future buyers to be able to see before they get what they're actually getting. I haven't even put them in my fish finder yet. I'm going to link my fish finders, my Simrad and my Lawrence, which by the way, they're both over 10 years old, but they're assuming that they're going to work. I'm going to link my tablet with both of them, one at a time, of course. I'm going to screen record this so you can see what I see in real time. And let's see how my map would transform from what I have now, the standard Lawrence map, to the 3D map the Strikelines provide. And also, because today's a nice day, I'll go to verify a few wrecks that I'll see from here. I don't know how far they're going to be. Like I said, I never plugged them in before. I do this with you guys, so bear with me. We're going to see if we can find a few wrecks from the verify wrecks, I repeat, and to see how the contour lines change and correspond with our fish finder. So should I start with a 3D Long Island Sound? Guys, I'm telling you, this is the first time I'm plugging this in my unit. How my base maps look right now. Okay, this is where I have many fishing spots, as you see. I'm fishing here for like quite a long time. This is the ocean sound, the ocean side, and this is the sound side. So I've been fishing here for like 15 years back and forth. And this is the spot that I have. You see these spots over here, all the way out to the right. Cross your fingers. I'm pushing in the card and let's see what it's gonna say. Let's press menu, more options, chart options. Is doing something before I even do anything. Did it? Well, you see, I don't even have to check, I don't even have to choose anything. All right. Guys, bear with me here. This is what we see. Wow. Okay, I didn't even have to choose it. It just came out of nowhere. Man. Anyway, let me see. Yeah, it is the chart option I have chosen, and this is on top of that. So, okay. Yeah, I know for a fact that this area by the buoy, look, it drops down. And here it is, something here. Oh, interesting. You see that, guys? There is something here too. Wow. Let me see here in the right of the... if he shows any rocks or anything. All right, here, according to the
the base map is rocks, and as you can see here, yes, there is this rock right here. Of course, I'm going to cover the numbers from the rocks here, because I don't want nobody to get any free information and burn this spot. Only the ones that want to spend the money like I did will have this privilege. Okay, see, I have marked rock here by myself, I don't know, a while ago, and I have caught fish, as you see to the right there. And it was right on the spot. Okay, let me see what it looked like without the map inside, without the card. So you see, this is what we see here without the mark inside. Without the map, we see nothing. I mean, that's my line there, means I went over there before. This is what I caught a weak fish 22 inches before. Anyway, this is what we see, guys, without the color scan contour map, which is not only the depth, you can clearly see the rocks and obstacles. I remember here in this area, as you can see here, I have marked from before huge malakia. You all know what that means in Greek. This part right here is marked in 2015. All right, that's way back. So let me push the cart now inside and see what is there. I will leave it alone and let it process all this information. I mean, my swimmer is too old to be doing this, and I'm surprised it does. I'm surprised it does. Okay, look. All right, you see? I've been up and down this area here, guys, forever. And this thing I have marked 6 years ago, it's right on the money on the map. I'm very impressed. Very impressed. I spent 6 years here up and down, left and right, fishing and always and constantly marking rocks, you know, nice bottom, rocky bottom, whatever I caught a fish. And as you can see here, I have these marks. Alright, this area over here I see is heaven, but I wasn't able to see these details before. And there is a lot more than what I have marked and found so far. Okay, this is great. Guys, I don't know if it helps you, but it can definitely help me. It can definitely help me. This is just in front of Montauk Inlet. Alright, let's go to this beach over here. This is west of Rocky Point, I mean Horton's Point, right? Yes. Oh, as you can see here, all this, everybody knows there's rocks there. I have marked a spot here. Look at this detail. Now, this is front of Horton's Point. That's where all the stripers are hanging out. This is where we fish for stripers, south and west to east, with the outgoing current. Okay, you see this? I have found this rock from before. This is from when? The 14th of the 7th, July. 14th of July, last year, 2020. I marked this mark on my fish finder last year, I guess, going up and down, back and forth. And I have also marked this. What is that? Is there a real rock here? Yes. I might not be on the money. I'll bet my money that the rock is right there. But I was pretty close. Wow. Wow. I'm loving this already. Oh my God, this is out of the nowhere. Out of the nowhere. Look at this spot right here. I've never been here before. How would I know to be here before? In the middle of nowhere between Rocky Point and Horton's Point. Okay, now let's go to Connecticut side, across. I've never been there, just once. When I first bought the boat in 2014, I drove all the way there one trip and then never again. Okay, this is the detail you see in the South Kingdom West Reef. Oh my God. Okay, guys, there's no need to say anything else. I mean, I'm amazed. I mean, if I have seen this before I decided to buy it, I wouldn't even discuss the price. This is unbelievable. I'm not going to tell you what to do. You can do whatever you like. I just love having this in my machine. And you can see what you will get. And this is only for the northeast side. I know they make in North Carolina, they make in for Florida, for California, I don't know. All right, look at, I've never been down here, but if I decided to go there, look at all these details. Look at all these details. Look at this mountain. This is Port Jeff. Yeah, I've been in Port Jeff, inside the bay. I've been inside the bay back and forth a couple of times in the winter. Screw around, but okay. That goes all the way down to New York. All right, look at this. So without further ado, I really want to go outside. Verify our back or two. Actually, since we're here, now also let me clear this and let me plug in this map right here, which is the verified Rex. Okay? So let me zoom out, leave that card there, and put it this way, I think, yeah. Okay. Right now, I just plugged the 380-something verified Rex on the sound, all the way down west to God knows how far up Black Island Sound. I think you can find this detail online. What I'm showing you here is what you're going to expect to see and how easy it is to set it up. I mean, I didn't even know. Okay, now look at this. The whole thing changed completely. I don't see the 3D bottom anymore. I gotta check if there's an option to switch between them. But let's see if we can see any wrecks. Okay. No, that cannot be. Okay, so these blue dots, it must be their markers. I don't want to confuse them with my markers. Okay, yes, so the blue dots are their markers. So we are here, and from here, the closest wreck, let me go back a little bit. Where's the, there you go. There is a wreck right here, number 533. That's the wreck, and it's verified by Strikelines. So this is where I'm going now. Okay, go to, of course I'm not gonna give you the numbers, guys, I'm sorry, but I don't want tomorrow to have 50 guys there. I mean, don't forget, this is the area that I'm fishing with, I mean on, and the last thing I want, it's everybody going the best spots, but those few that will decide to go the car, to get the car like I did, then they're gonna have the privilege that I have. So guys, how far away is from there? What a temperature, distant destination, 12 miles, god damn it. All right, and then from there towards west we have five, as you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And on the east, we have, so there is 4, 5, and 4 right there on the left, 9 wrecks within, I don't know, 15 miles away from Montauk Inlet. So, that's pretty good. I can hit these wrecks in a day if I want to. So, all right, enough said.
I gotta start fishing. I don't know how long I've been here and talking to you, but I love explaining this to you. I'm so excited, guys. I'm very excited. Now, when I go, let me go back and let me connect my Lawrence.
Chart options. Do I see what I see in the other one there? How come I see? Guys, this is beautiful. You see, I plugged in both cards on the sim rod. Of course, I have them connected and they do communicate like it's one unit. Lawrence and sim rod are 100% compatible. So, and I usually use my my Lawrence as a fish finder, has a bigger screen. That's where my fish finder is. And then my sim rod 9 inches, which is smaller unit, I use it for reference, you know, for a map. But right now, I have the 3D. Oh, and let me see the ocean side, guys. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Do they have it in the ocean side too? Oh, this is Peconic Bay. Oh my God, this is Peconic Bay. Look at this detail right here. That's Roger's Rock. Oh my God, look. Whoa. Okay, I'm not gonna, well, I mean, guys, there's nothing, no need to say anything. I mean, look at this. Look at this, it speaks for itself. There's nothing on the ocean side, but in the sound, oh my God. You guys can obviously see that it's worth it. So if you wanna have what I have, it's very simple. Contact Strikelines and get them for yourself. And you know what, since they were so nice and they were able to give me a better deal for making the video, helping you guys, which doesn't help me, showing you my, you know, fishing spots that are in my area, but we help each other. I learn a lot from, why am I looking at my tablet? I learn a lot from YouTube. I learn a lot of things from others. And what I realize is you give and you get and you give. And what happened is because of this, I got a better deal, like I told you. And I also manage, I tell them that I want to give to the people that are going to see my video and they're going to, you know, decide to buy it because they saw this video, which some people would have bought it anyway. But if this is this video, make up your mind to buy this, not for all in here, I guess the same way that will work in other regions as well. Make sure you get it from the link, affiliated link in this video below, and you can use the code Dennis10, promo code Dennis10. You're gonna get 10%. You're gonna get 10% from your next buy. So if you get two maps, $700, 10% is $70. One map is $35, and so on and so forth. So it's something. You're not gonna get this 10% anywhere else. Those people, they're pretty solid with the deal. They know what they have. That's why they had no problem with me making a video to show you what you're going to get. They're very confident. And as you see why. I mean, this is unbelievable. I would have spent years creating this map with my vessel, and I wouldn't be able to use it in any other machine. Because with these machines, you can record your own region. You can make your own maps. But how long do you're going to take to do this, you know, all these areas, and upload them and download them and put them in your machine, and then if your machine breaks or you decide to change it, you cannot transfer this data to the new machine. It's only made for whatever machine you made it on. This card is plug and play. You put them in any machine, Lawrence, Simra, whatever they have, and it's going to work. So I'm telling you what it does. Let's go outside and verify one wreck, and then I'll go fish, catch some fish for the dinner, for the table. It's so hot and I really want to be outside. So with that being said, I'm going to show you when I reach there what we see on the wreck, how it appears in the fish finder, maybe try another wreck too, and we take it from there. I think our job here, guys, is done. This is beautiful. Now you can see what I see as I'm looking at it. Okay, one, I don't know how, but one of the fish finders here, one of the sonars, shows me the 3D map. Mind you, they're both cards installed here, right? Which they will be coming home with me tonight, so I don't get any ideas. And then, for some reason, the first one that I plugged in, it appears here. I didn't do nothing. I mean, I would have probably tried to make this happen, maybe put the card there or something, but it happened on its own anyway, so I love it. Now, this is the way this looks with their Rex here. Okay, all these blue dots are Rex, and I'm not going to move the thing. So actually, yeah, I can move it. Oh my God, look at this. There is even 10 Rex all the way up to Black. Is that Black Island? Yeah. All the way to Black Island. This is Montauk Point. This is two verified guys. Mind you, this is verified. They said that they have actually verified those Rex are there. This is not marking on the maps we buy and then you go there and you never find it. And then over here, as I'm going there, look what I can see here. You see, I never crossed here. I never been to this area farther than this. I mean, I fished here. All right, this is on my way there, so 130 feet of water over here, huh? All right, guys, I found a new job. This is gonna be so many options and so little time. Once a week, it's not gonna be enough. But I'm pretty sure it'll be better going to a spot like that rather than going in the middle of nowhere just looking for stuff or looking where everybody else go. It's great. You go where everybody else goes, but doesn't mean the fish is there. And also, even if the fish is there, how many fish is left there when everybody's fishing there constantly? So I like spots that nobody knows. Only few. So, okay, anyway, enough said. Let me go out there and see what the wreck looked like. All right, guys, as I'm coming out, this is what I see. 11 miles. Look at all this promising area on the left of the buoy. What it says, 57. All these rocks, I've never been there before. Wow, on the way there, so many rocks. So many sea bass ground and fluke, why not? Just took a screenshot of the nets coming up and it corresponds with the fish finder. Guys, I just realized this wreck is right off the beach of Clinton, Connecticut. It was a long way, 10 plus miles. Probably I won't be coming here very, very often, but nevertheless, in here I'll go east to check the other wrecks we saw. The current here is ripping. According to the map, it's supposed to be 97 feet around here, 92 on the same length where the wreck is. Let me put this down. So let's go closely and let's see if it's gonna appear on the fish finder. Okay, when you zoom in, you can see it here too. So let's make this sonar. All right, I even see arches here. Look at this. Okay. So I'll take screenshots from that and I'll show you the seam rod. It looks like a big wreck. So look at what I see on the seam rod. And look what I see on the Lawrence. Picture five, screenshot number five. So as I'm approaching here, that looks like a big wreck according to the sonar. I've only been here once. So you know what? Let me put on the trucks of today, color yellow, perfect. Okay,
I see, look at this. I'm going to show you on the Lawrence what I see. Here it's coming up slowly. There was this gap. Look at this. So I continue that way. Let me put the side scan on. I see something on the left on the structure scan. You guys can see this. Is that thunderstorms? I won't be surprised, and I came all the way out here. All right, let's see if there's any fish on it. On the left-hand side, it was that, right? I see some arches. I haven't found the hard, solid thing of the wreck, per se, but I want to keep on the left. Don't forget, the current over here is ripping. I see some nice arches here. I wonder what this is. There is definitely some bottom changes here. All right, definitely see bait or stuff down there. Okay, guys, I don't know what the wreck here is supposed to look like, but we did see a difference on the bottom, and we do know there is this big lump over here, whatever you want to call it. I don't see on the fish finder any hard evidence, but this could be a wooden wreck for all you know. I have no idea what it is. All right, that's a little piece of wreck right there. That looks like a little wreck to me. It could be a wooden wreck, it could be any type of wreck. I don't know, we see fish, but we didn't get a bite. Now, let's go to the next one. Wreck number 534, 273 feet long. Okay, now what was this one like? I didn't know you have this information here. Wreck 533, distance, bearing, point. It doesn't say anything about size of this, so it could be something tiny. Anyway, we are 4.25 miles to the next wreck. There it is, guys. Look at this. As a matter of fact, let me put the Lawrence. Get out of here. You can see the whole boat, the whole wreck. Pay attention. Look at this. Can you see the boat? I mean, the whole boat. The marking is dead center. Top left, you can see the bow. Bottom right, you can see the stern. Get out of here. Look how the structure scan picked it up. Oh my God. Let's see what we see when we get on top of it. And let's be quick because I see getting dark in Connecticut. Yeah, stop so I can see better. Okay, look at this. What is my sonar saw? Nothing right now, okay? What about the structure scan? Nothing right now, but we are approaching. According to my GPS, I'm almost at the bow, almost. I mean at the stern. Right now I'm on top of it. Let me go slowly here. There you go. What the hell is that on top of that? Now we're drifting over to the right. I don't see no boats here. I mean, I see like 5-6 boats over there fishing and nobody right on top of this. I'll be surprised if nobody has this wreck over here. Let me see what the sonar says. Oh my God, you guys see this?
Okay, we're off of it to the right. Let's go up current. Look at this. Look at this. Let's put this together. Right there. Oh my God. Oh my God. Okay. Let me go right at the tip in the front. And go down with a tip rig because this wreck looks unbelievably intact. And you know what that happens? What happens when you go to a wreck like this? You lose all your jigs. Let me see the traction scanner. Let me see how to look at this. Wow. I've never seen a wreck like this. Let me see what the down scan image saw. Okay. Left and right. Wow. Did we pass on it? Did we left from it? Let's make it really quick because I see rain coming in Connecticut. Look at this wreck, you guys. Not for nothing, just for this wreck alone, I think it's worth every penny. You know why? Can you imagine the sea bass and the blackfish you will be hiding in this wreck? Unless everybody knows it and they've been fishing all day long. All right, this is the bow. Oh, stern. I mean, it looks like the bow to me. I don't know. All right, we're gonna drift over it and get out of here. The wreck is here. The current is too strong. Whether I catch a sea bass or not, I don't care. So as long as the wreck is here, I'm fine with it. All right, now we're going over the main wreck. Now we're gonna lose everything. Watch. Oh my God, look. According to the fish finder, actually right now we're getting off of it. We're right on top of it. That's a huge ass freaking boat. I'm sure somebody know the information of this boat. My boy will find out. All right, guys, this has sort of been 10 minutes video, and I'm pretty sure this is over half an hour. So this is just a starting video to see how it works and what it's gonna give you and what you're gonna see, all right? In the future, I'll be uploading videos with my catches and everything, and you can see then as well if it helps me or not. And especially in 2 weeks, June 23rd and over, after, when the sea bass were open, and me and my buddies are gonna be looking for 3 or 9 sea bass, depends how many we are, and we wanna keep nice size sea bass. So we'll be hitting these wrecks, looking for this precious fish, or even better, after we catch our sea bass or whatever, we can go for fluke fishing in the fluke grounds. And I'm pretty sure if I started this map, I'll find some nice fluke grounds where the ledges are, whatever, you know, they prefer, or the little scatter rocks. So if you have any questions or if there's anything else you want to see, you can ask me in the comments below. Like I said, if you want to get a 10%, use the affiliated link below this video directly, and on the checkout in the promo code section, put Dennis10. You're gonna see this over here reading. You're gonna get 10% of whether you buy 1, 2, 3, 5 maps, whatever, whether it's in New York, California, Florida, whatever. I think these guys deserve to be in business and to do well. And the better they do, the more maps they're gonna give us, and more detail they're gonna cover, they're gonna give us. So I'm gonna go catch myself fish. That's it. The review is over. As a matter of fact, at the same time, you can still see what it's coming up at the up of the screen. And so many things. That's it. I'm gonna continue filming if I catch some porgies in the end, when I'm gonna go up in the shallow. And that's it about this. All right.
spot for porgies. I marked, I took a screenshot from some stuff, you've never seen already. So you can see the details on Horton's Point. And I want to see the detail of this particular area that I was told from my friend that this is where we get big porgies, the beginning of the season. I don't know why, but he have found them there. And this is where I'm going to go now. Now, it's not early anymore. It's already first week of June. And the water temperature is already 64 degrees. They might not be here this shallow. I might have to go deeper. But while I'm at it, I want to try and see why they like this place. Can we see anything here on the maps? It looks like it. Let's see. And right now, the current is on the way out, almost at the low, at the lowest point. So this shallow, I don't think it's good for porgies, but it was a try. All right. I'm gonna have to. Right there. You see this? Number 19. All these rocks over here, those are rocks. This is not sandbars. So I can't believe they came even here and did this, whatever they did to make these maps. All right. I just hope I could get some porgies while I'm at it and go on my way. Guys, I'm very impressed with this stuff. Very impressed. I don't know if I told you this. Wow. And how easy it is. Just plug in and play. I mean, you don't have to do nothing. I thought that I have to go to the charts options and press something and figure something out and make it appear, but... And it seems to work in both machines, except when I zoom out on the sim rod, it kicks in as the basic, not the basic, their map with the rec points. If you zoom in closer, then it appears the sonar 3D view. So, but it's so good to have it on both screens. And I can always change between that and the other. Let's see what the bottom looks like. I mean, it's too shallow and I'm right on top of them. I'm not gonna see fish, but... All right, look at these rocks, you see? Look at this hard bottom right here. Exactly like they said. Picture 20. Now, okay, uh-oh. I don't wanna get caught in the buoy. Feel him? If we get 10 porgies like this, I'll be happy today. Look at this little thing. Huh. Picture 21. What did I tell you guys? This fish has been, look, you see this? Oh my God, that's, there must be a striper or a weakfish here. Oh wow. Are getting bigger. That was a nice fight. Be a good girl. Whoa, even this big porgies, something have a mess with them. A lot of porgies are like chewed up. Thank you.
not like before, but with a couple of French fries, it's a good, decent meal.
All right, guys, enough is enough. The rain, it's coming within a half an hour, maybe sooner. Hope I make it back, wash the boat, and be on my way before the rain starts. So, 25 porgies, very good size, less than a squid. Actually, I use the whole squid, small size squid. All right, I hope you like the review. Any comments or any questions, ask me in the comments below. Thank you and have a good one.